advantages with pace, you know.
Paul mentioned to us that before the Utah game, Pop talked about wanting you to face the basket more.
Mm-hmm.
Has that been a noticeable change to the whole offense, do you think?
Yeah, of course. That's one of the things, you know, that's been better in the past games. It's you know, we all trying to learn. For me, it was you know, maybe the fact that I didn't face the basket enough was also coming from the fact that I'm trying to be more patient from before in my career. So it's you know, it's always a matter of how we balance things, and I mean, that's how progression goes. We're gonna figure it out, but it's never gonna be a straight line.
How do things change both with you and with the offense in general when you are able to get that more face-ups, more space to face up, mm-hmm. things like that?
What changes?
Yeah, what
changes? So we tend to stop less, stop the ball less, and also, I mean, I consider the court better. And I guess it just, you know, it just gives us better momentum, and it's something we need. We don't do the ISO balls all the time like some teams.
You talk about the defensive effort. Seems like the defense is really starting to lock in right now.
Our defense? Yeah. It's for me, it's the only way, you know, to play basketball. It's can't be a one-sided thing.
What do you think of the connection between Jeremy and Chris so far?
I mean, it's great, you know. Jeremy has impacted the floor on so many areas just in those 5-6 games, you know. I mean, yeah, things are going well. I think we can pick up a good momentum. We gotta use it, and we're gonna build for tougher times.
How much do you think it helps Jeremy that Chris can get him some easy baskets in a row?
I mean, yeah, helps him very much, of course. But also, he's a good passer, so it helps everybody. You know, I think it can be one of our strengths. It's we got only selfless players on the court, so it's I'm thinking about one specific play where I think Harrison had a dunk, like a wide open dunk, just because we passed the ball around so much. It's we're getting closer to the, you know, that the Spurs philosophy is. Mm-hmm.
I've been making too much of this, but it seems like when Jeremy's happy, the team is happy. Do you guys feel that?
Of course. I don't know if it's a cause or a symptom, but it's definitely a good thing, and he knows how to turn things up for sure.
What's the dynamic like between you and Jeremy, since he's cutting a lot, he's mm-hmm. spending a lot of time around the basket? What's your dynamic there?
I mean, offensively, he's got a real role in punishing unfair helps from defenses. As we know him, quick guy, he can jump, and he's not a small guy either. So it allows him to be really, really efficient, to cover a lot of area. And he's making also, I think he's getting even better at, you know, punishing big men guarding him.
At this point, you've played with him a year plus. Are you mm-hmm. ever surprised when he's in the middle of these, let's call them arguments, with the other team?
Oh, no, I mean, no. There's nothing else to say. I'm not surprised. Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's part of the game. I mean, it can also be beneficial sometimes.
Mm-hmm. You could be getting Devin back this week and maybe Trey not too far after him. Are you eager to see what you guys can do with a full contingent?
I mean, I'm eager to first to share the court with those guys, Trey, of course, and then Devin. It's been so long. I can only hope that if they're as good as they've been, you know, that we can keep getting better like this. And I know they'll fit right back with us. So I'm really, really happy to have them back soon.
You had a couple of blocks on Rudy Gobert. Mm-hmm. As much as he means to you, does the fact that he won Defensive Player of the Year last year, does that enter into your mindset when you're facing him nowadays?
No.
Does he bring it up to you at all when you're with him at the Olympics?
No, not at all.
Going ahead to LA, I don't know if you've seen video or pictures of their new arena.
I have not. I mean, a long time ago, yeah. Yeah.
Are you looking forward to checking it out, or does that even...
I got other things to think about, but yeah. I mean, we'll see. It's not something I'm looking forward too much to see, but we'll see.
Did Jeremy not see you trailing on that three on the?
I think he's he might have seen me, but he chose the safe option. You know? Mm-hmm.
Your dunk would have been better than Julian's, though, right?
I think so. It's all right though. Yeah.
Six games in, has anything surprised you, or are you optimistic about where you guys are trending?
Nothing really has surprised me, but it's we've been facing new difficulties. I think teams take us more seriously also. You know, we've been facing different types of defenses, but my teammates have also impressed me in the way they've played. You know, I think about Julian, Jeremy, the way it's just been a pleasure sharing the court with them in only six games. The impact they got, especially in the defensive end, is just, as I said, it's a pleasure to play with them. So these are the things that surprised me. New difficulties and even bigger progression from my teammates.
The difficulties are what you mentioned, the defenses, how defenses are approaching you.
That's one of them. I mean, yeah, I think that's the natural course of things as we're a young team that grows up, but also you have different kinds of defenses that we just have to adapt.
Mm-hmm. Victor, how'd y'all get Keldon going tonight? A little bit of a slow start to the season, but he got going quickly tonight.
Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, it's, he's also a guy that we're ready to put responsibilities into, you know, into his hands. And he's ready to take him, you know. I think today really, really showed how much he can hurt, you know, defenses. So yeah, I'm really happy. How many points did he end up with?
25.
Yeah, season high. So he's, yeah, I'm really happy.
How was Coach Mitch?
It was good. It was good. Definitely not the same. What do you say? Like